have a draw at the end, and to participate, you get candy. Alhamdulillah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved sweets. And we have a table on the side over there as well, and they're waving. And so for that table and the table on the side over here, you can write your favorite hadith and on a post-it note, and we will put it up there so people can read and enjoy and be reminded of why we're here and why we follow Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's footsteps. So, without further ado, we will start with a recitation from Saifuddin al-Bakri. Is he here already? Is Saifuddin, are you here? I don't see him. Where? I don't see him. Did you guys see him today? Oh, he'll be here in 1 minute. Okay, so the kids here are really excited. Do any of you have a favorite hadith that you want to share? Okay, come up, Tamim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرج شطأه ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرج شطأه فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ بهم الكفار وعد الله الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات منهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما.
It was he who sent his messenger with guidance and the religion of truth for him to show that is above all false religion. Muhammad is the messenger of God. Those who follow him are harsh towards the disbelievers and compassionate towards each other. You see them kneeling and compassionate towards each other. You see them kneeling and prostrating, seeking God's bounty and his good pleasure. On their faces they bear the marks of prostration. This is how they are pictured in the Torah and the Gospel. Like a seed that puts forth its shoot, becomes strong, grows thick, and rises on its stem to the delight of its sowers. So God infuriates the disbelievers through them. God promises forgiveness and a great reward to those who believe and do righteous deeds. Sadaqallahu alayhi.
JazakAllah khair, Saifuddin. MashaAllah, that was a beautiful recitation. So we're going to go to this youth really quick who had a hadith. And
charity is good.
Alhamdulillah, thank you. MashaAllah, the kids are very well-versed. I would like to now invite Idris Al-Bakri, who's chair of the Manitoba Islamic Association, to share a few reflections with us on this day.
Thank you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. So happy that, you know, the mosques have been closed, open, restricted, but we welcome you here, and we welcome you for the sake of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I wanted us to try something. When I say Muhammad, I need to hear you. Muhammad? Okay, now pay attention. Who is your hero? Okay, I need to hear Muhammad like, you know, like hero, right? Who's your hero? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So having this event here is like a dream come true for me personally. And I'll tell you why in a minute, inshallah. But alhamdulillah, we would like to welcome all of you here. May Allah bless you. I want to thank the volunteers, almost all of them sisters who have put this together. May Allah bless them. In fact, many of the brothers who were scheduled to be in the program bowed out last minute, but sisters have been consistent. May Allah bless them. So welcome back to the mosque. And tonight is about trying to be an ummah wasat, trying to be a middle nation and strike a middle ground between claims that this is a terrible bid'ah and innovation that will end up in hellfire, and between the other extreme where Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's glorification goes to an extreme. We want to strike a middle path. And we understand that the scholars have classically and in modern times discussed this, argued about this, different positions, different perspectives, and we respect them all. We respect all these perspectives, but we are trying to find a balance, inshallah, a balance between these two extremes of not letting an opportunity pass to reflect upon the example of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to learn more about him, to ensure that our kids, when we ask them, "Who is your hero?" sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have the answer for that. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, So we're also reclaiming a tradition, not only historically in the Muslim Ummah, but even locally, You know, I have had in my position the privilege of looking through the archives of MIA, and back in the 1971 or something, or 72, you know, there were, I'm speaking to Sneem. Okay, you'll get your chocolate. But, you know, the community was getting together and talking about the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal. But for me personally, the Mawlid is also about identity and resistance. And I'll tell you why. Because we can't expect to grow a Muslim generation here without a strong sense of identity. And that can't develop if we only offer them Islam as a dry, boring religion, devoid of love, devoid of emotions, and devoid of culture. In fact, Islam should be the crucible and the vehicle of culture. And the Mawlid celebration, it's not an Eid, it's not a fart to celebrate this, but it's part of our cultural tradition that came about as part of our culture as Muslims. And for our young brothers and sisters to grow in as confident Muslims, they need a sense of culture here in Canada, and this is very important, this is part of it. The other part is resistance, and this is for me very personal, because where I come from, the Mawlid in the city of Jerusalem, Al-Quds, is an act of resistance, because they come after you, they try to disband your gatherings, they try to prevent you from celebrating. That means the occupation. In fact, this year, in Tashar Rabi' al-Awwal, they were going after people with this, it's a big vehicle that is full of sewage water, chemically treated sewage water, and they spray it on people. And so doing the Mawlid is an act of resistance. It's affirming identity of Palestinians as Muslims, and it's trying to show that we insist we belong to this land and we belong to this beautiful religion and this beautiful tradition. And so we do the same here as well, inshallah. Finally, tonight is about the candy for the kids, because if we ask them, who's your hero? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah, hold on. So it's about the candy, it's about the nasheed, it's about the reflections, but it's about being together as a community, but most importantly, it's about walking that path that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked. It's about walking that path Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked. It's about looking at ourselves and saying, here's an example. And tonight, hopefully each one leaves with a commitment that I'm going to be closer to that example. And you know, it's hard, because he set the bar very, very, very high, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we keep trying, inshallah, the effort that we put in will be, inshallah, will result in us on the day of judgment having the grace of drinking from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's hand, from the hout, from his basin, and then being with him in the akhirah, inshallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally, I remind you that, as the brother Al-Sifuddin recited, how were the believers described? The followers of Muhammad, وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ, those with him, how were they? Among each other, رُحَمَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ, they have mercy among each other. It's very, very important to spread mercy. Love is easy, because you love someone, you go take care of them, you serve them, whatever. But mercy, you sometimes have mercy against your enemy. And so we should be the people who raise the banner of mercy, because Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was God's gift to us, and he was God's mercy to us. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Jazakallah khair, Idris, for that wonderful reminder. So I'm going to ask a question, and then we can throw out candy very quickly before the next speaker comes up. So I'm going to ask the very patient little girl in the pink hijab to come help me. Can you help me? Come on up. So what's your name?
Maham.
So Maham is going to go through candy. I'm going to ask two questions, and the kids are going to yell out answers, and you're going to go through candy to the people who yell out answers. Grab the bowl. Okay, are you guys ready, kids?
Yeah!
All right. Okay, so very easy question. What was Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam's father's name? Throw candy. Just to everybody. That's fine. At the back. Over here. Over here, too. Okay. She's throwing candy. Keep throwing. Okay. Next question. Very quick. Keep throwing candy here, too. Okay. Next question. Very quickly. Which tribe were the relatives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Okay, good job, guys. Okay. So she's going to keep throwing candy while I introduce the next person. Just keep throwing. So, mashallah, our next person is a community member and a MIA volunteer, and he is going to present us with a wonderful nasheed. We have Brother Ammar Al-Miski.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما صدق الله العظيم. محمدا صارت دموع العاشقين تسيل. قمر 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 سيدنا النبي قمر. سيدنا النبي وجميل
وأجمل منك لم تر قط عين الله الله وأطيب منك لم تلد النساء الله الله ولدت مبرأ من كل عيب 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 كأنك قد خلقت كما تشاء قمر 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 سيدنا النبي قمر وجميل 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 سيدنا النبي وجميل وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي وعطرها يبقى إذا مست يدي وكف المصطفى كالورد نادي الله الله وعطرها يبقى إذا مست أيادي الله الله وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد وعم نوالها كل العباد حبيب الله يا خير البرايا قمر 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 سيدنا النبي قمر سيدنا النبي وجميل اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله
جزاك الله خير ما شاء الله that was so beautiful and thank you for everybody who participated so I just want to remind you, there's tables at the back. You can get more candy from the tables at the back. And you have to just answer a quiz. And they have bowls of candy. And there's quiz for adults and for kids. And you can also write your favorite hadith on the post-it over there. And you get a piece of candy. So, but before we do that, so good. So while we're doing this, while we're doing this, we have a youth from the community. Guys, you have to take the quiz and fill it out and give it in, and then you can get candy, okay? But you can do it by yourselves. So we have a youth from the community, youth in MIA Leadership Youth Committee. Her name is Leen Jindi to share reflections with us very briefly. Leen.
Assalamu alaikum. Whoa. Assalamu alaikum. I'm here to share my reflections on what I have been seeing lately on social media. Something we may all be able to reflect on, inshallah. A few days ago, I had read a blog about an individual who has left Islam because they felt too overwhelmed. I questioned this reading and I decided to do my own research as to why anyone would find such a peaceful and beautiful religion so overwhelming. When I did this research, the first link brought me to a title that stated, "Why You Should Stop Making Islam Difficult Upon Yourself." And so I clicked it. Then I read a hadith that truly touched me, narrated by Abu Huraira. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Religion is very easy, and whoever overburdens himself in his religion will not be able to continue in that way. So you should not be extremists, but try to be near to perfection and receive the good tidings that you will be rewarded, and gain strength by offering the salah in the mornings, afternoons, and during the last hours of the night." One misconception that many individuals have due to the spread of lies is the idea that Islam is made to be a rigid and an extreme religion. However, the meaning of Islam is peace and submission. And the greetings of Assalamu Alaikum directly translates to "Peace be upon you." I thought I'd share this as a reminder that Islam adheres to basic human psychology and human nature. One of our sunnah practices includes something as simple as a smile to your brother or sister. Don't make this religion hard on yourself. We are not made to be perfect. Gain strength from your prayers. Find the middle ground of how you live your life and how you practice your religion. And inshallah, you'll find everything to be at peace. Jazakumullahu khairan.
Jazakallah khair. Thank you so much for that reflection, Lena. And so if all of you listen to it, it was very easy to make Islam and our religion easy on us. We're not perfect. So sit down. So I'm going to ask another question. So who's going to help me throw the candy? One person. Oh my God. Okay, we'll get him. Okay, so whoever answers the question, you can throw the look over there too. Okay, ready? Is everybody ready for the question? Okay, what are some very simple acts of charity that the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to do? Keep throwing. Here too. I hear smile. Smiling. What else? Zakat, giving charity. Okay. Okay. Jazakallah khair. What's your name?
Bassam.
Jazakallah khair, Bassam. Let's move on to the next part of the program. You can take one. That's it. Okay, for our next part of the program, I would ask you to settle down, please. We have a next part of the program, so I will invite Sheikh Ismail to share a few reflections on this day. Jazakallah khair.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa mbala amma ba'd. First, I would like to express my gratitude and my appreciation for the blessing of coming together. COVID-19 kept us away for a long time. So it's so pleasing to see everybody coming together as a family. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this night a blessed night. I just want to remind you that we are still under COVID restrictions. So make sure you put your mask and keep as much as you can some social distance between you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, addressing our beloved Prophet Muhammad, may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon him. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have elevated we have raised your name, your reputation, your memory. There is no one today whose name is so passionately remembered across the globe other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Think how many azans and how many iqamas are made all over the world. We make 5 times azan, 5 times iqama, and every time we make an azan and iqama, we say, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. I bear witness that Muhammad is his servant and his messenger. And this is repeated not in one place, not in Mecca, not in Cairo, but everywhere in the world, from the mountains of Afghanistan to the deep Sahara, to the furthest corners of the world, everywhere, every day, multiple times, the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is remembered. So many nasheeds, so many poems, so many books. And that's a fulfillment of what Allah said, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have elevated your name, your memory. Our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was unique among all the prophets and all the important figures in human history. There is no one who we know so much about more than the Prophet, may the peace and blessing be upon him. There is a book called Zadul Ma'ad, and it's about 5 volumes. And you read this book, you would be amazed. Chapter after chapter gives us a description of the Prophet, what kind of foods he used to like, what kind of foods he used to dislike, what kind of dress he used to dress, his physical appearance, his facial expressions, even as far as how many gray hairs he had in his head and in his beard. He mentioned that the Prophet only had 20 gray hairs. So what happened was the generation that came after the Prophet, they were, you know, they felt sorry that they missed the opportunity of meeting and seeing the Prophet. So they were asking the companions, please tell us about the Prophet. And the companions generously told them everything they knew about the Prophet. So we know so much. And everything that pertains to the Prophet, we refer to that Sunnah. So there is the physical aspect of the personality of the Prophet. But more importantly, we should learn the essence and the substance of the character of the Prophet. And one thing we know, that for the people of Medina, he was not only their prophet, he was their father, their mentor, their teacher, their counselor. Families who have dispute, they would come to him. People who have questions, doubts, they would come to him. Youth who were struggling with their own urge, they would come to him. Elders who have struggles, they would come to him. He would welcome them all with so much love and with a beautiful smile. He loved children. We have many stories of the kind of relationship he had with children. There was a child that the Prophet nicknamed Aba Umayr. He nicknamed him as Aba Umayr. And he had a small bird. And the Prophet would come and ask him, how's your bird doing? ماذا فعل النغير? One time he found him sad. He said, what happened? He said, my bird died. And the Prophet sat beside him, comforting him and trying to make him smile and be happy. We are told that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes he would be leading prayer, and his grandson would come and step on his back, and he continues in his sujood, doesn't want to disturb his grandchild to the extent that the companions behind him think that something might happen to the Prophet. The Prophet then would tell them, my grandson was in my back and I did not want to disturb him. Even when he prays sometimes, he says, I want to make my prayer long, but I hear the cry of a child in the back, and I know because that stresses him and the mother, I shorten my prayer. That was the extent of the love of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and care for the children. He used to greet them, he used to chat with them, he used to tell them jokes. Our beloved messenger was an excellent teacher. One of the companions known as Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, a brilliant student of the Prophet. Later, after the death of the Prophet, he was sent to Iraq to teach the people of Iraq. Is there anything there? Something there? Yeah, so he went to teach the people of Iraq, and the people of Iraq were asking him, teach us every day, lecture us every day, remind us every day. He said to them, no. The beloved messenger used to remind us on and off so that we will not be bored. His speech used to be short and concise. So he was considerate of his audience. Further, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was an approachable, easy, friendly person. He used to make jokes with the people around him. There was a man known as Zahir, a Bedouin, who was a friend of the Prophet. So one time he was in the market. So the Prophet came behind him and he put his hands on his eyes. And the man didn't know who was this. Then the Prophet started saying, who is willing to buy this slave from me? And the man, when he realized it was the Prophet, he said, Prophet, I'm worthless. Nobody would buy me. Prophet said, no, you are not worthless in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. An elderly woman once came to the Prophet and said, oh Prophet, make dua for me, make supplication for me so that I enter paradise. He said, don't you know that old women do not enter paradise? The woman was surprised. Prophet told her, when you enter paradise, you will be young. Don't worry, you will be young. So that's the kind of a man our Prophet was. The most loving, the most caring, the most approachable. Even when he teaches people, if somebody does wrong, he would not yell at them, he would not scorn them, he would not mock them. He will kindly and gently and lovingly teach them and guide them. Sometimes we hear in our mosque some people who would ask, ban children, do not bring them prayer time. They are making noise, they are shouting. Yes, certainly we should discipline our children, but that's not the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We should welcome everybody in the house of Allah with love and compassion. And that is how we revive the sunnah of the Prophet. We would be deceiving ourselves if we think by simply growing a beard or by simply having an imamah, we have revived the sunnah, then we are deceiving ourselves. The essence and the substance of the sunnah of the Prophet is character, personal character, interpersonal relationship. And if we have that kind of interpersonal skills of the Prophet, everybody will love us. Our neighbors will love us. Everybody who comes to this place will feel comfortable and welcome. Our children, our elders, everybody would feel comfortable in our company. ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us follow the legacy and the example and the sunnah of our beloved messenger. Jazakumullahu khairan. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Ismail. And as you guys all heard, Sheikh Ismail said that the Prophet ﷺ loved kids, right? And I'm so happy, and we're all so happy to see so many kids here. So thank you for being patient. Thank you for listening to the program. And now we have another nasheed by Brother Amar. So hopefully you can join in, right? Jazakallah, did you guys know that nasheed?
Yes.
Okay, so at the end, after we listen to maybe two more people, you guys can tell us which nasheeds you know, and Brother Amar can help us with them. How's that? Yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so I would like to now invite youth, Aya, who is a member of MIA Leadership Youth Council, and she's going to share a poem with us that she wrote. Oh, she didn't write.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. I will be reading to you a poem called Who is Muhammad by Farhat. What a year was 570. A person was born, a prophet to be. Muhammad, that was his name. People were misguided, and that's when he came. He would go on to leave all the idols behind. He's an example to the whole of mankind. Rabi' al-Awwal, and it was a day he came to this world to show us the way. He was born in Mecca, the holiest place, a life full of challenges he was to face. Abdullah, his father, had by then passed away, leaving Amina in her arms he lay. Halima Sa'diyah took over his care until he was six, our prophet was there. His mother then died, he was left all alone. Abdul Muttalib, his grandfather, then made him his own. When our prophet was nine, his grandfather died. Abu Talib's uncle became his new guide. In his 20s, a merchant Muhammad became by trade. Al-Amin, the trustworthy, became his grade. Khadija became his bride. He was 25 with her by his side. To the poor, she gave away all her wealth, a dedicated wife in sickness and health. 360 idols in the Kaaba, they were all at that time. Our prophet realized that this was a crime. He would go to Mount Hira, leaving behind his wife, reflecting and wondering about the meaning of life. Whilst thinking there in the midst of the night, he heard a loud voice which filled him with fright. It was the angel Jibreel who asked him to read. Our prophet couldn't and didn't take heed. The angel embraced him and then asked him later, read, read in the name of the Creator who created man from a drop of blood. Our prophet couldn't read, but at that time he could. Our prophet rushed to the path straight ahead. He heard a voice from the heavens which said, Muhammad, truly you are the messenger of Allah. Muhammad was scared and thought this quite odd. Praise be to Allah, his wife said instead. I know you've been chosen as Allah's messenger, she said. And thus Khadija became the first woman of Islam, and over the next 23 years came the revelation, the Quran. He preached to all people, every creed, every race, yet so many hardships he had to face. There were fears for his life, then the hijrah took place. He entered Medina by the Almighty's grace. He was greeted by the Ansaris, who were not like the others. They treated the Muhajirs like their very own brothers. Then came the battles fought face to face. Then the conquest of Mecca, Muhammad's birthplace. And Nasr was revealed, its message was clear. Muhammad knew that his time was near. Everyone gathered to hear his last speech. Little did they know how far Allah's message would reach. Muhammad gave us the miracle, the Quran, and now a quarter of the world follow Islam. He's our role model, the best of mankind. He has left the Quran and his Sunnah behind. Read the Quran as much as you can, the words of Allah for the guidance of man. And follow our Prophet's Sunnah when eating and dressing, and send him salutations and many a blessing. He came to mankind to show us the way, and inshallah we'll meet him one day. Jazakumullah khairan.
Jazakallah khair, Aya. That was, mashallah, beautiful and was summarized the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's life. So we have another nasheed, and I would like to invite Muthasi, and he will lead us in a nasheed. I think the kids might know this one, I'm not sure.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyid al-Mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammadin ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. It's a beautiful evening. It reminds me with the students in Al-Hijra Islamic School when we in a gathering at the school for graduation or any event. So it's a beautiful thing to see all those young children there here. And it's a beautiful thing to talk about Sirat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is nothing better than that. He's our leader, he's our teacher, he's our Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khuluq al-hasan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. And there is nothing better than al-khuluq al-azim. And that's what we need to teach ourselves and teach the young ones in there al-khuluq al-azim. And that's what we couldn't succeed in this world in there because of that. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, revealed to him about the Quran and said, وَإِنَّا نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. I just want to mention something happened last week. Four of our young children memorized the entire Quran, mashallah. And there was something going on in Bilal Masjid. We should say takbir, because those three of them, they were up to grade 9 in Hijra Islamic School. So we are very proud of them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant this to all the children, all the young ones is coming up in this beautiful city of ours. So normally we have a maulid at home, and but nice is to see more gathering. Our gathering is about 30, 35, but here there's in the hundreds, mashallah. So what we're gonna do is do al qasid al muhammadiya, inshallah. So we're gonna start.
مولا يا صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. مولا يا صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد أشرف الأعراب عجم. محمد خير من يمشي على قدم. مولاي صلي وسلم ما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد باسط المعروف جامعه. محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد تاج رسل الله قاطبة. محمد صديق الأكوان والكلم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه. محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد دينه حق ندين به. محمد مجمل على عالم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد زينة الدنيا وبهجتها. محمد كاشف الغلام والظالم والظلام. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد سيد طابت مناقبه. محمد صاغه الرحمن بالنعم. مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم. محمد ضاحك للضيف مكرمه. محمد جاره والله لم يضم
مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم
محمد قائم لله ذو همام محمد خاتم للرسل كلهم
مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم
اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه وكل عام وأنتم بخير جميعا إن شاء الله إلى next مولد إن شاء الله السلام عليكم
Jazakallah khair, Ammu. And thank you for the kids who joined in. You knew this one, right? Yeah? Okay, hold on. Okay, come up. Okay, put this up here. All right, one last question. This is your chance to get candy, guys. One last question. And this is a difficult one. Are you ready for a difficult question? Yeah? Okay, now you have to finish this hadith. Are you ready? Listen. Oh, listen carefully. Shh. Careful. Okay. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Here. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, be in the world as if you were a Okay. Okay. Sit down because after this we do have some sweets and stuff in the gym too, so you will get more. All right. So for the end of the night, mashallah, I am going to the last reflection that we have. We're going to have spoken word by a youth in the MIA Youth Leadership Committee. Dujan, I'm going to call you up.
Okay, that's it.
Listen carefully.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. Before I start, I would like to give a brief history on the poem and the writer of the poem. So the writer of this poem was the Chinese Emperor Heng Wu. He was the first emperor of the Ming Dynasty in the 14th century. He was a great supporter of Islam, and he built many mosques in China. And this is probably very shocking in contrast to what we see today. How the Chinese government is persecuting Muslims in China. So I would like to say, inshallah, they will be free one day, and please keep them in your dua. Okay. Since the creation of the universe, God had decreed to appoint this great faith-preaching man. From the West he was born and received the Holy Scripture and book made of 30 parts. To guide all creation, master of all rulers, leader of the holy ones, with support from the heavens to protect his nation with 5 daily prayers. Silently hoping for peace, his heart directed towards Allah, giving power to the poor, saving them from calamity. Seeing through the darkness, pulling the souls and the spirits away from all wrongdoings, mercy to the world. Transversing to the ancient majestic path, vanquishing away all evil. His religion pure and true, Muhammad, peace be upon him, the noble and great one. Thank you.
Jazakallah khair, Dushan. So, Alhamdulillah, thank you everybody for staying. We will end with a nasheed, inshallah.
وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم أشجار ساجدة تمشي إليه على ساق بلا قدم كأنما سطرت سطرا لما كتبت فروع من بديع الخط باللقام مثل الغمام أن سار سائرة تقيح رواطيس للهجير حامي أقسمت بالقمر المنشق إن له من قلبي نسبة مبرورة على خير الباري يأتي لم تنسج ولم تحومي وقاية الله أغنت عن مضاعفات من الدروع وعن عال من اللطم ما سماني دهر ضيما واستجارت بي إلا ونلت جوارا منه لم يضام مولاي صلي وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله.
All right. Assalamu alaikum. Jazakallah khair, everybody, for attending. We will have Isha Adhan in 2 seconds. I would like all the children, I'd like to request them to please pick up all the candy wrappers. We keep our masjid clean, right? Right, kids? So excellent. And we also had Nasheed plan in different languages, but we had somebody cancel. So inshallah, next year we will have Nasheed in different languages, okay? So see you guys next year, inshallah. Well, come to the masjid every day, but still. And now it's Isha. Sorry.